exercises of the lesson The Necklace Part 2. Question 1. Complete the following table where we have the utterance, meaning the sentence spoken by someone, who said it to whom, and now an added dimension, when. So I touched it in the hall at the ministry, said by Mathilde to Monsieur Lozelle when she realized that her necklace was missing. It will give us some time to look some more, said by Monsieur Lozelle to Mathilde when they couldn't find the necklace. I might have needed it, Madame Forestier to Mathilde when Mathilde returned the necklace late. You must have made a mistake, Madame Forestier to Mathilde after 10 years when Mathilde met her and told her about the necklace. Well, I lost it, Mathilde said these words to Madame Forestier when she finished repaying all her loans. Mine was an imitation, Madame Forestier said these words to Mathilde after Mathilde confessed that she had lost the necklace. Next question. Write what you think about the following thoughts and actions of Mathilde. Now you have to write about what you think about the action that Mathilde has done. What Mathilde does and what is your thought about it. Now the first one is Mathilde despaired over the loss of a necklace. She was very worried. What do you think about it? She was worried because she knew she couldn't afford to replace the diamond necklace loaned to her by her friend. Mathilde wrote a note to a friend as dictated by her husband. So what do you think of that? Why did she write the note? Because she wanted some more time to look for the necklace. Third one, Mathilde and her husband decided to replace the necklace. They looked for the necklace for a week. They couldn't find it. Okay, that is why they decided to replace the necklace. Mathilde returned the diamond necklace to her friend. What do you think about it? Because it was already late and excuses had already been made for her by her for the delay. Next one, Mathilde did not tell a friend about the loss and replacement. Why? Because Mathilde was embarrassed about her negligence, her carelessness, and she was a proud person. Mathilde worked very hard to pay the debt, the loans that she had taken, because she knew that it was her fault for being greedy and wanting to be rich that they were in this situation, because she wanted the diamond necklace. Next, Mathilde and her husband paid off the debt in 10 years. They worked hard and together they saved every sou and paid off the debt. Mathilde told a friend about the lost necklace. Now they had finished, they repaid the loans and now she was free from all the guilt she was carrying, all the stress and the burden she was carrying. So she told a friend about the necklace which she had lost. Imagine what must have happened after Mathilde's friend discovered that the diamonds were real. Do you think she would return the necklace to Mathilde? Would that make Mathilde happy? Personal response question where you have to write what you feel that could have been the situation. Okay. So, Madame Forestier was a wealthy person. Though she was snobbish, she was also kind and generous. She must have been shocked to know the necklace Mathilde returned was a real diamond necklace. She must have returned the necklace to Mathilde when she heard of the bad situation Mathilde was in, because she was kind and generous. And I think Metal would be happy that she got the necklace back, as it would improve her standard of living. She would be able to afford more and live a more comfortable life. The difference would be that now she would have better values and appreciate the life that she had with her husband much, much more. Discuss and write about each in your own words in 5 to 6 lines. What would you do if something like this happens to you? Now, this is your personal response. Okay, what would you do? Only you know. So therefore, this answer should be written by you yourself. Okay. Next, what opinion do you form about Metal's husband from her story? Now here we have proof to show that Metal's husband was an honest, kind, hardworking and loyal husband. He loved his wife and stood by her even in times of trouble. He could have easily blamed her and refused to work towards paying off their loans. But he worked with her side by side, and both of them managed to come out of the trouble that Metal had put them into. Okay, so we have a very kind, considerate, caring, loving and loyal person. Which events in the story, now with part 1 and part 2, changed Metal's life? Okay, so from part 1 we have the first event that changed Metal's life was when she got married to a minor official. Another life-changing moment came when they received an invitation to the party. Then, her life changed drastically after she lost the necklace and had to live through hard times, poverty and stress. Another life-changing moment was the time when they finished paying off all the loans for the necklace. In this question, you have to read the table of verb forms, recall and remember. All this is something that you have learnt before. In the first column, we have the base form of the verb. That is the base form when we don't add tenses, you know, change them into different tenses, add an ed or an ing, only the verb by itself. Okay, now an infinitive is the base form of the verb. So you know an infinitive is 2 plus the base form of the verb. So we have infinitives which go like this, to go, to eat, and like this you can make infinitives, to give, to draw, to eat, etc. Next is the S form of the verb. The S form is the verb in simple present tense. He goes, she eats. Okay, so we add an S and that shows us that it is the simple present tense of the verb. We next have the past tense. Okay, most of the verbs are changed into past tense by adding ed at the end. For example, show, showed, allow, allowed, shop, shopped, skip, skipped. But there are different ways to make the past tense of verbs, and we have different forms like drew, climbed, went, come, came. Okay, so the past tense can be made in different ways. Next, we have the present participle, which is an ing form which shows continuous action, like I am eating. He sat copying a manuscript. So a participle is a verb which is used as an adjective. It does the work of an adjective. Okay. Next we have past participle. This past participle is used with forms of have to show completed actions. For example, I have eaten. He has collected the parcel. Okay, and most of them have an N at the end. Okay, But we have different forms like said, come, gone, etc. So see, one verb here, this is the base form. Then from give, we change it to into past present tense by adding an S. Then give becomes gave in the past tense. The present participle of give is giving, and the past participle of give is given. So one verb in the base form, and we have different forms of that same verb. You have to make a table of verb forms and try to arrange them in alphabetical order. So take 10 verbs, make the first column of the table that you just seen and write those verbs and try to arrange them in alphabetical order. You know, alphabetical order is the order in which the alphabets come, you know, A, B, C, D, etc. Now, list at least 10 verbs, the last letter of which is doubled in the present participle. For example, the base verb is put, and so the last word is doubled. Putting, skip, skipping, shop, shopping, rob, robbing. Okay, so have 10 words like this, which in which the present participle, you form the present participle by doubling the last word. Next question is, list at least 10 verbs, the last letter of which is doubled in the past participle. Like write, we double T, written. Okay, so you make 10 verbs to show the past participle. Next question, list at least 10 verbs, the last letter of which is doubled in the past tense form. Sob becoming sobbed. Okay, rob becoming robbed. So you have 4 different questions here. Understand the difference and write down what is asked from you. Thank you.